In this video, we will try to understand what is swarm intelligence and we will use different examples to understand this concept. So first we have what is swarm intelligence. Swarm intelligence is a collective behavior displayed by swarm of simple groups. Here the simple groups interact locally with one another and their surroundings. So here we have a swarm of simple groups. So in these groups, these agents could be animals, insects, or even simple algorithms in the artificial intelligence. So this concept is inspired by the behavior of social insects like ants, bees, termites, and other animal societies. So their real life behavior is simulated to solve different optimization problems. Swarm intelligence silent features, you can see here: self-organization, decentralized control, robustness, adaptability, scalability, and emergent properties that we already discussed in the previous video. So we can use swarm intelligence in different fields, include optimization, robotics, in computer science, finance, economics, and other. So we can solve different optimization problems. Even we can also use these algorithms to solve real life optimization problems. Now here you can see the example of algorithms inspired by the swarm intelligence. So most popular, we have particle swarm optimization algorithm, ant colony optimization algorithm, bee colony optimization algorithm. So like that, we have different algorithms. So these algorithms are used to solve optimization problems, mimic the foraging behavior of ants or other insects, and they explore the search space efficiently to find out the optimal solution. Now we will try to understand the swarm intelligence using an example. And in this example, we will use social insect ants. So imagine you're watching a group of ants on the ground, and each ant is a tiny worker with a task to complete. Here, the ants are searching for the food to bring back to their ant hill. Now, these ants don't talk to each other like we humans do, but they are really good at working together to find food. Now, let's try to figure out how ants can do it without any communication. So first we have scouting behavior. So first we have some scout ants. So a few ants move in separate direction in search of food. And when the ants are moving, they are leaving a trail of scent behind as they go. And when any ant finds food, it follows its own scent trail back to ant hill. And on the way, it leaves behind extra strong scent trail to tell other ants. So here the scent is also known as the pheromone that is deposited by the ants on the path as they move. So first we have the scout ants who are moving in the different direction and searching food. Next, if any ant find out the food, they are leaving the scent trail, or you can say they deposit the pheromone trail on the path. So that's how they communicate using the scent trail. They use the scent trail to tell other ants that they found food this way. After that, other ants pick up the strong scent trail and follow it to the food source. Other ants are also traveling. They are also, in this case, they are leaving trail with even more scent. They leave behind the scent on the path, and so that other ants can follow it. That's how they communicate using the scent, or we can say using pheromones. After that, other ants start following the path, and when all ants are following the same path, soon lots of ants are marching back and forth along the same trail, carrying food back to the ant hill. And here they are following the strong scent trail laid down by their fellow ants. So even though each ant is tiny and don't know what the other ants are doing. Together they form a smart, efficient system for finding and collecting food. So this is like swarm intelligence. Each ant follows simple rules like follow the scent trail and interact with its neighbors to complete task, that is finding food, so without anyone in the charge. Scientists and engineers study different social insects' behavior and they simulate this behavior and create computer programs and robots that can solve problems like finding the best route for the delivery trucks or searching for survivors in any disaster. Now let's try to understand swarm intelligence with another example. This time imagine you have a big factory where you need to assemble products like toys or cars. You have a lot of different parts and you need to figure out the best way to put them all together quickly and efficiently. So here we want to save the time and we also want to do the task quickly. So in this case, you can program a big robot to do everything, but this might take long time and there is a probability that it is not that much flexible if something changes. So instead of working on one big robot, you can use the swarm intelligence to solve this problem, like how ants work together. Here we can set up a team of small robots. In the team, some robots are good at picking up certain parts and others are good at fitting them together, and some are good at checking if everything is done right or not. So each robot follows simple rule like pick up this part or put it here, and they talk with each other to coordinate their actions. So as they work together, they figure out the best way to assemble the product quickly and without making any mistake. So if any changes occur, like new parts come in or any machine breaks down, they can adapt and keep working efficiently. Like that, we can use swarm intelligence in various real-world scenarios beyond engineering and robotics. For example, in the traffic management. Imagine you are stuck in a traffic and you want to find the fastest route home. So by using data from GPS devices in car, like in your phone, traffic lights, and the road sensor, traffic management system can apply swarm intelligence algorithm to optimize traffic flow. So this is similar how ants find the shortest path to the food source. And we can also use this in the healthcare. So using swarm intelligence algorithm in healthcare, we can analyze huge amount of patient data to identify the pattern and make predictions. So this algorithm can help doctors determine the most effective treatment for specific diseases by analyzing how different treatments have worked for similar patients in the past. Like that, we can use in the finance. In the finance, we can predict the stock prices, or we can use for the environmental monitoring, disaster response, and other. You know, the traveling salesman problem. So here, let's try to understand how we can solve the traveling salesman problem using ant colony optimization algorithm. So here we are using the swarm intelligence to solve a real world problem. So now imagine you are a delivery company trying to find the most efficient route for your delivery trucks to deliver the packages to the different customers in a city. So this is the traveling salesman problem. So here we need to find out the shortest possible route that visit all locations exactly once and then return to the starting point. Now, if you will try to figure out the best route all at once, it can be complicated with many stops. So here we can use the swarm intelligence algorithm, that is ant colony optimization algorithm. This algorithm is inspired how ants find the shortest path between their nest and the food sources. So here we have simple steps how it works. First, we will initialize a group of artificial ants randomly. They are placed at different cities. Then we will start the exploration. Here each ant starts moving from its current city to the next city based on the certain rules that we already discussed in this video, the number of rules, mathematical models, and other. Here, ants may choose their next city based on the factors like distance, pheromone trials. So next we'll update the pheromone, because as ant travel, they leave behind the pheromone trials on the path they take. The shorter path get more pheromones, simulating the idea that the shortest path are more attractive to follow. Ants are more likely to follow the path with the stronger pheromone trial, creating a positive feedback loop where shorter paths become even more attractive over time. So we repeat this process for many iterations with ants exploring and reinforcing path until a satisfactory solution is found. So by simulating this process, ant colony optimization algorithm can be used to find the near optimal solution to the complex optimization problem, like traveling salesman problem. Now we have different swarm intelligence advantages. Swarm intelligence algorithms are often highly scalable, capable of handling large-scale optimization problem with many decision variables and constraints. And in swarm intelligence, the agents in the swarm can quickly react to the changes and adjust their behavior accordingly, making them suitable for the problems with evolving conditions. And this makes them suitable for the problems with evolving conditions. These algorithms converge quickly to near optimal solution, and these algorithms are straightforward, easy to implement, require simple rules for individual agents and communication mechanism for sharing information, and they often have fewer parameters to tune compared to other algorithms. It makes them more accessible to user without extensive optimization expert. Swarm intelligence algorithm explore the search space using a population of search agents that interact locally with each other and share information. So these algorithms provide us complementary approaches for solving optimization, coordination, and control problem in dynamic and distributed environments. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.